Do you take a run at Yasiel Puig, who is a free agent, who can impact the baseball, as they like to say? Now, there's a lot of other stuff that comes along with Yasiel Puig, but I don't know.
Well, he's a handful, but Aaron Boone, I think, could handle him. I think Donnie Mattingly did a pretty decent job with him, although he did show up late for opening day. But I think he's got the best arm in baseball. Puig is an unbelievable gun in right field and can hit and can run. He is just a bit of a problem. He's not a Yankee guy. Like, he just isn't cut from that mold.
Puig kinda loves everybody.
He kind of, marches to the beat of his own drummer. I'd be very careful bringing him into a room because he can be great or he can be disruptive. I mean, you can't say you can't win with him because the Dodgers came close, right? They went to a World Series with him. But he is, that's given a lot to handle to Aaron Boone, to drop him in your lap.
Well,
but he's a phenomenal player, but there's a reason why he's bounced around here, because he's a handful.
Desperation sometimes leads to jump-starting innovation, and that might be what they're thinking about, because are you really going to go into the season with that starting outfield? And I'm not saying it's not good enough, because Tauchman showed, obviously, a lot of skill last year before he got hurt before the playoffs. We know that Clint Frazier's bat plays up here. Is he going to be able to play every day defensively? And then Andujar's just learning how to play the outfield. He's just learning. Tyler Wade can play the outfield. He's got skills. He can play the outfield. And are you going to play Brett Gardner every single day at that age in center field?
Well, ask yourself this. With that outfield, are they still the favorite to win the division?
I think they come closer to the pack, Don.
All right.
I don't know if you believe me. I think they come closer to the pack.
But do you want to make a move that can be disruptive because you just want to secure being a team that's going to win the division by 10 games rather than 5?
Well, I don't think that you could dismiss how good the Rays are. I don't think the Red Sox are a threat at all. But the Rays are really good. They won 96, 97 games last year. Now, Snell's injury, they're searching around with his elbow. That would hurt them a lot. But they've got a very deep farm system. They have the best prospect in baseball, and Juan DeFranco, who's a shortstop. So if they wanted to go out and make a big trade, they would never trade him.
Right.
But they've got a great farm system. So I don't think you could assume we're going to win because we're the Yankees.
Obviously you can't, and you just can't assume that the guys that are going to play the outfield are going to duplicate what they did last year. But you have to ask yourself, can we get by without them? How long can we get by without them? And what kind of move are we going to make? Puig is very intriguing to me because I think he fits what's missing.
And
it's absolutely free. But would you admit to me he's a handful? And does Aaron Boone want to have to deal with him?
Well, I mean, just from the outside looking in, he looks like he's a handful.
Now, maybe.
For sure.
Now, maybe, because this might be his last chance saloon, wouldn't be the first time that somebody came over and all of a sudden starts flying right with the Yankees. Right? Because let's face it, things are a little bit different in Los Angeles. You can get away with a lot more with the Dodgers and the fan base and all that. He's been in Cincinnati. It doesn't matter as much because they're not in contention. Maybe he'll fly right as a Yankee.